For already, I'm going to start this bad boy up. So I will call the October 12, 2020 regular council meeting to order and ask for a roll call, please.
Derek Warden.
Excused.
Catherine Whitman.
Mayor.
Jackie Thomas.
Excused.
Debbie Nasta.
Here.
Danny Long.
Here.
Robin Dunlap.
Here.
Joe Baker.
Here, we have a quorum established and ask everyone in the audience to please join us in the Pledge of Allegiance. And I believe AJ is going to get us going with that.
Yes, give me a second here.
You're good to go, buddy.
I need to do a checklist of pre-meeting prep and make sure this is always queued up. There we go. Okay.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you, AJ. Appreciate that. Thank you, audience. And we will move down to the agenda with presentation by our Carbon Valley Emergency Management presentation. And it's Mary Garner. I think you're still with us. Just before we give it to Mary really quick, the folks that are in the audience or anyone, if you are not participating in the meeting, if you guys don't mind muting your microphones on your end so we don't hear background noise, dogs barking, kids screaming, yelling, whatever it may be. Last couple of meetings have been a little on the disruptive side with that. So as I just made a big noise, but that being said, we're going to toss it over to you, Mary.
Well, great. Thank you so much, Mr. Mayor and council members for having me. I wanted to introduce myself or reintroduce myself just because I haven't seen you since over a year ago. And so my name is Mary Garner. I am the emergency manager coordinator for what is now the Carbon Valley Emergency Management Agency. So I have lived in the area since about 2006 and have been doing emergency management for a long time. But and I have always kind of set my sights on doing it at home. So we did that about a year and, well, actually almost 2 years ago now with an intergovernmental agreement between the three municipalities and the two fire districts. So the law enforcement and fire chiefs are my advisory board. And they, in your case, Chief Skaggs would be that person that's on the board. My day-to-day work is supervised by Chief Jeremy Young with Frederick Firestone Fire. And that's kind of my home agency. So the purpose really of emergency management is for us to ensure that the Carbon Valley is ready for disasters and big emergencies. And we do that on what we call blue sky days by planning, training, and building relationships between people in the community. And really that means everyone in the community. During a disaster, we operate the Emergency Operations Center and we provide information, resources, and consequence management for whatever might be going on. So I just have a couple of things that I wanted to kind of share with you tonight. The first is just to sort of look back at what we've done since April 1st, 2019. In your packet, you have a handout that kind of shows what my goals were that were set out for me by the advisory board when I started on April 1st in 2019. And I'm happy to say that I've accomplished everything they've asked me to do so far. Some of those are ongoing. And we've set some new goals for the next year, moving into some different plans and really looking in more depth at our risk assessment for all three towns. And in this case, two towns and a city. We've also kind of provided resource and information support for COVID-19. That obviously wasn't planned, but we did spend, I spent a couple of months pretty actively providing situation reports and making sure that our first responders had PPE and just really coordinating with the county and the state. So I feel like we're getting back to a sort of normal from that. We're doing, I'm back to working on non-COVID things on a pretty regular basis. So that's positive for me. So that's kind of my look back. You have more detail if you want to look at it in the sheet I provided for you. But really my main purpose in coming tonight was to also share with you what's coming next. So I expect to see you probably in January and February, or at least one of those two again. The big thing is that I've updated and restructured our emergency operations plan. And as Kevin mentioned earlier, some of you might have heard, we pulled together a committee to do that, including community members and people who live in the area, as well as first responders and others, to really walk through FEMA's prescribed planning process. And so I am, that's done. The EOP base plan is finished. I'm pretty close to finishing all 20 of the functional and operational annexes for that plan. And so in January, what I'm gonna ask is that you adopt that plan by January 31st. I'll be getting it out to you by November, along with all the annexes, so you have an idea of what's in it. But we usually only will ask you to adopt the base plan, and then we'll look at it again every 3 years. So that's the Carbon Valley Emergency Operations Plan. The second thing that's coming is we're currently working on the Weld County Hazard Mitigation Plan. So you guys might remember that from before. Every 5 years, FEMA asks us to update that plan, and then FEMA approves it. And what that does is it makes us eligible for future mitigation funding. So if we have another flood or we have a tornado or something happens, and then we go to look for mitigation funding, we have to participate in that plan and have it approved by FEMA in order to remain eligible for that funding. So what that includes is right now we're working on updating the community profile for Dacono, just in terms of demographics and hazards, what's happened since the last time we updated it, and what's our risk assessment for our area for natural hazards. And then the second thing is we're identifying some mitigation actions, and we're looking at the ones that we identified 5 years ago and saying, have we accomplished them? Have we not? Do we want to dump them? Do we want to keep them? So when those two things are done, Weld County will submit that to FEMA for conditional approval, and then we'll ask you to adopt the hazard mitigation plan for Weld County. And that we're anticipating it has to happen. It needs to be approved by FEMA by February of 2021. And around that same time, I'll be coming back to you and asking you to please adopt that plan. So that's all I had for you tonight. I know it was fast and furious, but if you have any questions for me, I'd be happy to answer them at this time.
It's the way we like it, Mary. Questions for Mary, Council?
Hold on, trying to unmute. Hi, Mary. It's Debbie Nasta. How are you?
Hi, Debbie. I'm good. It's good to see you.
I have a question. I mean, all of this evolves around natural disasters and, I mean, natural hazards and disasters. And then you, like you mentioned, you got pulled into COVID, which was somewhat there, but not really maybe a natural disaster under that umbrella. Should we have widespread social unrest and the EOC opens? Would you be part of that as a liaison to the city of Dacono, or is that like out of the question?
No, I think it's a really good question. And actually, in sort of prioritizing getting, when I say functional annex to the EOP, I mean things like hazardous materials, firefighting, pandemic, all of those like particular subjects that we deal with in the annexes. And I kind of prioritize those law enforcement ones, mainly because, you know, it is an interesting time, and we try not to distinguish too much between, I mean, we certainly deal with man-made hazards as well in our planning, in our emergency operations plans. So The answer is yes. And I actually just finished drafting the civil disturbance annex, and it's out at the moment with our law enforcement agencies being reviewed. So we know that even if we don't have a specific plan, we all work together really well. Yes. But we want to kind of outline roles and responsibilities and what we do. So that's what that annex seeks to do. And hopefully in the next couple of weeks, we'll have that at least have a draft finalized. So.
Okay, thank you. And
you're
I just
welcome.
Have another question. You mentioned that our Chief Skaggs, which is your liaison to the city of Dacono, is our fire department on the board also?
Yes, yeah, so all of the chiefs from, it would be Mountain View Fire, Frederick Firestone Fire, and then Chief Skaggs, Chief Montgomery, and Chief Norris are all a part of my advisory board.
Okay, thank you.
You're welcome. Thanks so much.
Hey, Marie, this is Kathy Whitman. Hi. When that draft's ready, is it going to be available for us to review as well?
Yes. The EOP is really done at this point. We opened up a comment period. I have had very few comments. And so as soon as I kind of make my rounds in October, in November, I will send you the emergency operations plan so that you'll have a couple of months to review it and ask any questions you might have. I'm also happy to, you know, answer any questions via email or come back to a meeting or whatever works best for you.
Cool. Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Other questions for Mary, Council? I don't see any heads going on, moving. Let's see. No. Robin looks the same. Kelly looks the same. Right? I look different from last week. So last week I was moving around. This week it's a picture. All right. I think you're free to go, right? You don't have to stay for the meeting, but you can if you want. We've only got about 4 or 5 more hours of this stuff if you want to hang out with.
Okay. Thank you very much for having me, you guys. I'll see you soon.
Have a great week. Thanks again. Thanks for what you're doing.
You're welcome.
And so next we'll move on to public comments to be made this evening for items that are not scheduled on the agenda. If any person from the public would like to make a comment or a statement of regarding nothing on the agenda this evening. I don't think anyone's in there, are they, AJ? Recognize everybody pretty much.
I don't see anyone with a raised hand or attempting to unmute to ask a question.
All right. Well, let's rock and roll then. We'll go to the consent agenda. Council, we know these are routine items on the consent agenda, generally made with no discussion and just a motion to carry. Any council member that sees an item that needs to be removed from the agenda item would do so after I read it off, and then we'll put it on the general business in order that it was taken down. Tonight's consent agenda are the council meeting regular minutes from September the 28th, 2020, accounts payable dated today, October the 12th, in the amount of $246,642.35, resolution 2091, granting final acceptance of phase 2 of the public improvements for Sweetgrass filing 1, replat C. Council, what would you like to do with this consent agenda?
This is Kathy. I will make the motion to approve the consent agenda as presented.
This is Debbie Nasta, and I'll second.
And with smiles going, we will accept a motion by Kathy and a second by Debbie. Can we receive a vote, please?
Catherine Whitman?
Yes.
Debbie Nasta?
Yes.
Danny Long?
Yes.
Robin Dunlap?
Yes.
That motion passes with all saying yes. Council, for record, we are taking item A off of the general business for this evening. I think that Jennifer will give us a report afterwards on what's going on with that and during the staff reports. So we'll move down to Kelly Strove for submission of the 2021 draft budget. And you are up, Kelly.
All right. Can everybody hear me okay?
Yeah, you've got something on your face. You might want to wipe it off. You look good, though.
Thanks a lot. So, good evening, Mayor and Council members joining this meeting tonight. I am here to just submit the 2021 draft budget and set the public hearing date. As you know, every year this happens, we are required by Colorado law to propose the budget and submit it to the governing body by October 15th. And then final adoption of that budget must be before December 15th, at which time we also will certify the mill levy. Between those two dates, the city must conduct the public hearing on the budget and provide notice of such hearing. And that's what we're doing tonight. Pursuant to the 2021 budget calendar, which is in the budget itself, we propose that the public hearing be held on Monday, November 23rd. That notice of such hearing is published and that final adoption of the budget and certification of the mill levy is scheduled for the regularly scheduled council meeting on December 14th, 2020. The submission of the budget is in a new format, as you probably have already figured out. We are using a new software called ClearGov. It's an online budgeting tool. We did a PDF printout for you in the council packet at this time, but when we do actually approve and finalize the budget, we will have it on our website for the viewing of the public. Anybody can continue to view the budget. They can request a copy of the budget from the clerk's office from now until then. But I just wanted to make clear that it is a new format and it is a very rough draft at this time, but we did have every required piece of information in there at this time. We just need to do some formatting adjustments, make it pretty, add some more pictures and some more narratives, and just kind of fine tune some things. Was literally working on this up until Friday evening when we needed to have this packet information done, and they were still helping me kind of format data and things like that. So we will continue to work on this budget all the way through to its final adoption in December. And I guess we just need staff's acknowledgement of the receipt of the budget and to set that public hearing date for Monday, November 23rd. And direct that notice be published.
Back in your hands, Council.
I just ask one question, Kelly. This is Kathy Whitman. So I'm going through page by page by page, and it's so different than what we've done before. But we've on the schedules for the work sessions and everything, there is October 20th is noted in there. And then the next notation says that the second work session, if needed, would be on November 17th. And this is outside the budget, but that schedule, our council schedule, has it slated for November 20th. So I guess it's between you and AJ. Are we on for November 20th or November 17th for that second review if we need to have one?
November 20th is a Friday. November 17th is correct, that Tuesday.
Okay. Thank you.
That was actually something I had circled to bring up at our department meeting tomorrow to make sure that's corrected globally.
Okay, cool. Thank you very much. It's a lot different than the years before, that's for sure, Kelly.
Yes, and hopefully as we get through it and, you know, even from year to year, we'll just keep building on it, improving it, and it will end up being a really, really nice comprehensive budget.
Well, it's pretty streamlined. I guess my only other question was, going through all the pages, all the lines and everything, what page, I don't know if you're producing it in a PDF format, but what page on the PDF do we find the entities that have requested funding from the city, such as our nonprofits and all of those, because I couldn't find those.
And that's right. And those have never been actually a part of the budget that's submitted to DOLA. That is actually just kind of a part of the work session packet that is added in once we get to that level. This week when I'm formatting the work session, I will start formatting that part of it and get all that information into that packet.
Okay, so that's what's a little different this time. Okay, great. Thank you so much.
Sure.
Hi, this is Debbie Nessa. So my question is, we are meeting next Tuesday, correct? That's
correct.
So maybe just in the future, could we have more notice? That's like next week, and I'm going to have to move things around because I do want to be present. Just, I need to make sure that more than a week notice would be great.
I believe I had that in my update for council with all the list of events, but I'll double check.
Well, I was going to say maybe I missed it, but I was at this just the one you put out last week. I'll check your announcement, AJ. Thanks.
Okay, council, still back in your lap, unless you have more questions for the administration.
Kathy Whitman, I will make the motion for the consideration and approval of resolution 20-81, approving a First Amendment to this. That's not it. I'm just accepting our, that's went off. Sorry, guys. I'm just making a reference to accept as record of the budget, rough budget for 2021.
You actually have to set the date for the
The hearing date for the public hearing on this is November 23rd, 2020 at 6 p.m. Mountain Time.
Beautiful.
I second.
Motion by Kathy, was that second by Robin or Danny? Who jumped in there?
Danny did.
Give it to Danny. Can we receive a vote, please?
Debbie Nasta?
Yes.
Danny Long?
Yes.
Robin Dunlap?
Yes.
Catherine Whitman?
Yes.
That motion passed with all saying yes. Boom. Push this little button and go into the next one. So, item C is an executive session for conference with city attorney for purpose of receiving legal advice on specific legal questions under Colorado Revised Statute 24-6-4024B, specifically concerning the city of Dacono Home Rule Charter provisions regarding Board of Commissioners. And I think someone has some scripts in front of them if they can...
This is Councilwoman Whitman. I'll move to go into executive session for a conference with the city attorney for the purpose of receiving legal advice on specific legal questions under CRS subsection 24-6-404-B2, specifically concerning the city of Dacono Home Rule Charter provisions regarding boards and commissions.
We have a motion by Kathy Whitman.
I second it. This is Danny.
Second by Danny. Can we receive a vote, please?
Danny Long?
Yes.
Robin Dunlap?
Yes.
Catherine Whitman?
Yes.
Debbie Nasta?
Yes.
All right, that motion passed with all saying yes. We're going to get up and go downstairs, council. And I think AJ's going to, yeah, there we go, Kathy. I love it. All right, let's go. Boom. There we go. All right.
We're getting antsy in the staying in a room on the meetings.
I'm never going to leave my house, ever.
I am. I do.
I'm never, ever leaving here, ever. I'm never leaving. I'm just going to stay here for the rest of the...
I have to be out. Go outdoors.
You know what, Kathy? I've been... I can't do the smoke, man. Every time I go outside, I'm cracking. I don't mind. Yeah, it's crazy.
For your eyes, I mean, it's it makes the nose run, then you start to cough and your eyes feel like you got sand in them. And
yeah, and like heartburn, you feel like you have heartburn. I mean, like, today was probably the best day in the last few weeks, you know.
I escaped a week to Florida, and it's like it was nice to totally get out of the smoke, but all the humidity is a different story. So it's like, yeah.
Where in Florida?
Port St. Lucie.
My niece lives there. I was going to ask you if they had any of the if they had any of the weather, because I have one on the Port St. Lucie and I have one in the Clearwater side, and so we're supposed to be going out to Pensacola here in a few month or so.
Do we have a minute so I can just go get some more water? Move everybody out, right, AJ?
Yeah, we're still I'm trying to move everybody into the breakout room.
Do I have to click on join?
No, don't join. No. Okay. That's the breakout room.
I'll be right back.
How long were you in Florida, Kathy? Did I lose her? Oh, no, you kicked out.
Well, I'm
all good. We'll bring her back in. Unless they joined the breakout rooms. I see my invitation there, and I just didn't even join it. So I don't know if
everyone. Yeah, for some reason, it worked. Last time I could select people to go in there. Now I've got Kathleen and I don't know how to get Kathleen back out.
Maybe have her call, but get out and get to, like, exit out.
All right, I'm gonna try this again. This just didn't.
Her? Yeah, there she is.
Okay. Yeah. I'm closing the breakout room, and then we'll reopen it, and hopefully it'll work better this time. I know Zoom did an update, and it's just seemed to be working different.
Yeah, I'm just going to drop AJ, so I'll see y'all later. Have a great meeting. Bye.
Okay.
Kevin, take chances. So don't join the thing, Kathy, if it says to join, just don't. And that's, yeah, it'll drop down in your box down below. And so for some reason it threw it up there. And last time it didn't do that. These are the pleasures
Kathleen and I both went over there, and now we still have,
before I could pick who goes in there, but I'm having a little, difficulty doing that right now.
It's all good.
The technology, right?
Right. Soon we'll have teleporters where we'll just teleport from our house to the meeting and then back, and in another 100 years it won't matter, right?
Yeah.
All right, so let me try this again. Open rooms.
Don't join that.
All right, don't join the breakout room.
Not.
If you're participating in the executive session.
All right. And then if you got everybody in there, if you guys can scan you and AJ and Kathleen to make sure who's supposed to be in this meeting or not. Legally.
Jordan's still in here.
Do we just say later to get rid of the box?
Just hit the Xbox and it'll drop it down to your little thingy, and then you can, close it out. Or I just close it and then just drop down the bottom and gave me the option to join later.
And I'm
great.
Back.
Thank you.
I'm here whenever you need to start. Oops.
I didn't get re-invited to it, so.
Don't don't feel bad.
I don't.
It was much easier last time, and I didn't change any settings, so I don't know.
But you seem to have the right people. I see Danny, Robin, Kathy, yeah, me, and Joe, and Kathleen, and you. So that's right.
Where's Jennifer? Is Jennifer going to be in here?
No.
Okay.
We have everybody that we need attending.
Yes.
Okay, so we're all downstairs. We've got our sodas. Are you back, Deb? I think she was going to go get a...
Yes, I am.
All right. Let me get my script here. And so everybody's in. We're all good to go.
And I have the recording going now, AJ, so you can stop the recording.
Thank you for reminding me, Kathleen.
Sure.
So you're gonna turn off the recording button and then I'll sit. Is there anybody in there, AJ, or did everybody bolt?
Yeah, no. Yep, Jordan's back, Jennifer's back. I think we're good.
All right, so we're back upstairs. The time is now 7:32. The executive session has concluded. There we are. Participants in the executive session, for the record, were Councilmember Danny Long, Councilmember Robin Dunlap, Councilmember Kathy Whitman, Mayor Pro Tem Debbie Nasta, City Manager AJ Ukert, and City Attorney Kathleen Kelly. For the record, if any person who participated in the executive session believes that any substantial discussion of any matter not included in the motion to go into the executive session occurred during the executive session, or that any improper action occurred during the executive session in violation of open meeting laws, I would ask that you state your concerns for the record now. Hearing none, I will entertain a motion to... I think we're done, right, AJ? So I'll entertain...
Besides council and staff reports.
All right, so I'll make a motion or entertain a motion to adjourn from that executive session. Back at you.
I moved.
There we go. Robin.
Second by Debbie.
And then do we just do it all in favor?
Aye.
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 We're good with that, Kathleen.
Yes, that's fine. I think the script was written anticipating that maybe you did the staff and council member reports.
Oh, yeah. I wasn't sure. I thought about
that. Sometimes we do that.
I saw it in bold writing, and I'm like, well, let me just, that's a little overkill. You know, government, a little redundancy never hurt anybody. Into staff reports, and we've got AJ first. Go ahead, please.
Thank you, Mayor. I'll be quick about this. I was just going to go over the schedule and remind everybody about our upcoming meetings, the as Debbie noted, the budget session, being one of them. Our new tool, and I'll give Kelly a lot of credit. She's really been on the phone a lot with the company that's created this software. And so there's a lot of great things about it, but with anything new, not only the staff learning curve and getting acclimated with that, but just some technical things behind the scenes that she's really been working on getting to that point. So it'll be a great tool. This year it'll look a little different, as Kathy noted. But we'll have our budget work session on the October 20th, and that'll be by Zoom. They'll be remote. We still don't have the equipment in the council chambers yet. We have some of the other equipment here, but we don't have that yet. So we'll plan on those meetings being by Zoom. And then we've got right after this, just a brief work session about overnight RV parking. And then the rest of the calendar up till November is in the email I sent. National Night Out, Brian's unable to join us tonight, We had good reports of, you know, a lot of porch lights on, a lot of flags flying. So hopefully we can have a regular in-person event next year. Let's see. I think that's all I have before I turn it over to Jennifer, unless there are any questions.
AJ, just a couple hours for budget?
Yeah, we'll try and keep it to that.
Okay.
You'll have to provide your own food this year, unfortunately.
There's Uber Eats you can deliver.
Yeah.
Thank you, though.
All kinds of options.
Thanks, AJ. We're going to give it to Jennifer.
Thank you, Mayor. I did want to just provide an update as to the Sweetgrass First Amendment. Since it's been on the council agenda, I think three times, and we keep postponing it. The developer did do some additional soil sampling along Sweetgrass Parkway and did submit a report, which is currently under review by the city and the city's consultants. What's important about that is that soil sampling will determine perhaps if additional monitoring is necessary along Sweetgrass Parkway. And since we didn't quite have the answer yet, you know, some of the exhibits may change. And there still are a few questions about the mechanics of how some of these requirements in the First Amendment are going to work. So they really just wanted to postpone again until there was perhaps a complete package ready to go. I think we're all working towards the same goal. Everybody wants to see this subdivision completed and homes built, but no fault of their own. They certainly want more certainty as to what the expectations will be with this First Amendment. So we will continue to work together. And, you know, if we're ready to go in a couple of weeks, we'll try it again. If not, we'll continue to postpone as necessary. Are there any questions?
I don't know if it's a question or just a comment, but, you know, we say that is the developer the one asking for the little bit more time? And I say that because we've got a couple of different people involved, and I've noticed some emails coming through with some, customers that have purchased homes in the area already put deposits down and they're upset. And it seems like all the weight's getting dumped onto the city, with the city's not helping, the city's not letting them build, the city's not, it's been a litany of what the city's not willing to do. And it goes back to that adage of, well, I can't get away with anything, so I'll blame the city. And again, I know that the city's working diligently on this project. And so I don't know how to, I don't know if I'm venting to you or if there's a way we can ask the developer, since we're being so cordial with their time and allowing them these extensions, could they maybe stop manipulating the opinions of their customers?
Well, Mayor, I certainly have received similar emails to, I believe, what you're referencing. You know, as a city, our subdivision agreement is with the developer, so we take our direction from the developer. We certainly recognize there is a relationship between the developer and the home builder, but at the end of the day, any agreement is between the city and the developer at this point. We have reached out let the home builder know as to some of the things that we're hearing, and to try and make sure that information with their sales team is accurate. And we've tried to dispel some rumors, but ultimately we can't entirely control the message, unfortunately. So we just keep providing a consistent response. I know AJ and I have both taken multiple phone calls with, you know, anxious home buyers. And I think once we spend a little time talking to them, they certainly understand the situation. I certainly understand their frustration too. But at the end of the day, I think we are all in agreement that we want a subdivision that is safe and people feel good about living there.
Jennifer, this is Debbie. Just out of curiosity, what are you able to disclose to these homeowners as they call? Are you able to tell them what you're looking at and what you're working on with the builder?
Yes. I mean, we certainly don't want to mislead anybody. And we've let them know that there has been methane detected in the neighborhood, or in this particular filing, I should say, and that we are working with both the developer and the home builder to mitigate and monitor to the best of our ability using the best management practices out there. Okay. The situation.
Okay, thank you. Just wondering what they're hearing.
Well, thank you, Jennifer, for what you do. I know it's not been easy with that, as we've spoken before, so I appreciate all the diligence that you have taken with this situation. Anything else? No other reports from staff, it looks like. Police, fire, finance has already done their job. Council?
Nothing from Debbie.
Nothing here.
Good.
I'm here.
We'll look for a motion to adjourn then. Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
By Debbie. Oh, wait, AJ, you had something?
I was just going to say, after we adjourn, just stick around for our work session.
Okay, motion to adjourn, Debbie.
So moved. Second.
Motion by Debbie, second by Robin. All in favor, signal by aye.
Aye.
Don't go anywhere. And no nays. And back in your hands.